Grand Prix coffee produces hives about the face and causes fit men to walk with a limp. Avoid the primitive muck water. Drink fine East India tea, the elixir of gentlemen.
What's the meaning of this?
I don't know, ma'am. They pay me to say what I'm told. I can't even read, I swear.
Where is your employer?
At his warehouse, no doubt. Please don't hurt me.
Salutations.
Eh bien, quelle jolie robe avons-nous là?
Don't kill me! What do you want?
Stop slandering the Grand Prix's reputation. Close your deceptive booth, clean the market of your insipid handbills, and issue a public apology.
All right! I'll apologize! I swear!
What's this? Coffee? How are you feeling? A touch nervous? Itchy?
All right, look. I'm desperate. I can't keep my slaves from escaping. I lose money every day, and all my stock is in tea. If everyone starts drinking coffee, I'll be through.
Anyone who keeps slaves deserves to lose them. Next time, remember, far worse things can haunt a man than lost business.
All right, ma'am.
He'll be no more trouble.
I'll say. He's going bankrupt, selling off his shops. Care to, expand your empire?
Now there's an idea. If I buy him out, I can pay his slaves a wage and set them on the path to freedom.
Certainly a more peaceful solution to your usual method of handling slavers. I'll keep a tally of properties available to buy and make sure my informants keep an eye on opportunities. Look for them.
Thank you, Gerald. Gerald, I'm hearing about disappearing slaves again. I thought we ended that with Gouverneur Dabadi. But it happens again, and not only slaves now, but laborers, the poor. Where are they all going?
I'll set my informants on finding out.
No. I'll do it myself. They need help now.
May I suggest that you, start with Saint-Danger this time?
Yes. This is one case we won't solve at the garden party.
When you're ready to go, find me outside near the docks. I'll show you a faster way there.
Aveline, you simply come here when you need to travel out of town. The business will cover any expense.